हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज़ एके गुप्ता, योर इंग्लिश फैकल्टी, आरसी स्कूल बांसुर। एज वी नो दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो फ्यूचर इनडेफिनिट टेंस। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट फ्यूचर कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टडीड प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस, पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस एंड फ्यूचर कंटिन्यूअस टेंस इज गोइंग टू बी कंप्लीटेड इन दिस टेंस। हियर इज वन थिंग, व्हेन anything, any action is going to happen in the future with continuous, and or any action is going on continuously in future, continuously is going on with in future, that is a future continuous tense. Suppose if I will say that she will be going to school, means that action will be going on, okay, at the time in the future, okay. So similarly, if I will say I will be teaching you on Monday, okay, same thing is here, okay. Principal sir will be checking your notebook in the 8th period on Monday. So means everything is planned. Everything is a planned for the next day, next week, or next month, like a future. In future, if anything is planned or if anything is going to be happen in the future, so that is uncontinuously. Means continuously, so that is called a future continuous tense. Okay, let's see some rules. Rule first, an action which is going on continuously in future. Okay, so whatever I have written on board raha hoga, rahe honge aur rahi hogi, and in English an action which is going on continuously in future, okay. So this is called a present continuous tense. Rule second, subject. Shall be, will be plus first form of the verb plus ing. So my dear, subject shall be, will be plus first form of the verb plus ing, that is a second rule of future continuous tense. So I think you have taken screenshot and you have remembered this, or otherwise you have written it, okay. Now come to the next rule. Come to the next rule, that is the lesson number 11A. In that we know very well, I, you, they, we. I shall be and will be, they will be, we will be, okay, he, sorry, we shall be, will be, she will be, it will be, name will be, who will be. Okay, so my dear students, these helping verb will be used according to the present continuous tense, future continuous tense, and according to subject. If I will be here, so we will use shall be. If you, they, we will be here, so you, they will be, and we shall be. He, she, it, name, who will definitely include with the will be. Okay, I hope you have taken a screenshot, otherwise you can write on your notebook. In a notebook, thereafter let's see some more examples for getting better understand. As I have told in the starting that how can we use the future continuous tense, which and any action which is going on continuously in the future, that is called future continuous tense. Like that, I shall be teaching you English grammar on Monday. Okay, she will be making tea for you. Okay, my father will be teaching me English or math on that day, which day he has a holiday. Okay, so this type of sentences we can create. Okay, let's see some examples. First, I shall be playing there. You will be going school on time. Who will be teaching in 10th class? Who will be teaching in 10th class? Why will they not be studying here? Okay, that's interrogative plus negative. Interrogative with the WH word why, and negative is here. So why will they not be studying here? Similarly, when shall we be gossiping gossiping here we can use double P. Okay, gossiping with him. Wait my dear students, I think you are not able to watch this whatever I have written on board. Now at the time you are able to see, you are able to watch whatever I have written on board. Okay, sorry for that. Now I think it has been completed. Okay my dear students, let's see all the sentences, all the word, and let's see more examples. Okay, here for 6. Why will you not be making him understand stand. Okay, similarly you will be going there. For that work, so my dear students, I think these examples will be enough for you, and I know very well that you have got it all these things. So my dear students, now start to be habitual, start speaking English, use the old chapters, use the old sentences for making understand, for getting understand while speaking. That means if you will use more and more words, more and more English speaking, so that time you will be good speaker and you will remove your hesitation. While according to my method, if you will keep speaking English, so that time after some days, few months after, or you will be definitely good speaker. Okay, so for the next video, we will meet in the next video. Thank you.